Right now, in this very moment, millions of people around the world are doing something that seems harmless, grabbing a quick snack. Maybe it's a bag of chips, a handful of fries, or even that crispy fried chicken from their favorite fast food joint. It's convenient, it's tasty, and it's everywhere. But what if I told you that this simple, everyday habit might be speeding up the aging process, stealing years from your life before you even realize it? The food that many of us eat without a second thought is silently causing damage. What I'm about to reveal might shock you, but it's crucial that you understand what's happening every time you reach for that fried snack. Today, we're going to uncover the science behind a specific type of food, one that's not just unhealthy, but actively accelerates aging, both internally and externally. This is the food that's causing premature aging, right before our eyes. So, what is this food? And more importantly, what can we do about it? Stay with me as we dive deep into the answer. Let's talk about fried foods. Whether it's the fries you get with your burger or the potato chips you munch on at home, these foods have one thing in common. They're often cooked in oil that's heated to extremely high temperatures. That might not sound like a big deal, but here's where the science comes in. When oil is heated above certain thresholds, like the 150 degrees Celsius mark, it produces a chemical compound called acrolein. Acrolein is the same substance released from car exhaust during combustion, and yes, it's present in that crispy fry you just ate. Acrolein is not just bad, it's one of the most carcinogenic substances known in solid foods. This chemical can cause cellular damage and inflammation, wreaking havoc on your body's ability to repair itself. Over time, this leads to premature aging, both on the outside where you can see it, and on the inside where the real damage happens. You might be wondering, is this really that serious? I only eat these foods in moderation. But here's the catch. It's not just about how much you eat in one sitting. It's about how often you're consuming these foods. The frequency with which we expose ourselves to harmful substances plays a bigger role than most of us realize. Let's break this down even further. Our cells have an incredible ability to repair themselves. Every day, your body is fighting off toxins, repairing damaged DNA, and keeping your organs functioning smoothly. But when we repeatedly introduce harmful compounds like acrolein, we overwhelm our cells' natural repair mechanisms. Over time, this constant exposure to toxins wears down our cellular defenses. Here's where things get really concerning. Studies show that the acrolein produced by fried foods damages something called elastin, the protein responsible for keeping your skin firm and youthful. As elastin breaks down, your skin begins to lose its elasticity, leading to sagging, fine lines, and wrinkles. But it doesn't stop there. This breakdown of elastin also affects your arteries, leading to a loss of flexibility that can increase your risk for cardiovascular disease. So, while you might not notice the immediate effects of eating that portion of fries today, what's happening under the surface is far more alarming. Your skin, your arteries, and even your organs are aging faster than they should because of the food choices you make daily. At this point, you might be thinking, okay, but what about air fryers? What if I'm using a healthier oil or frying at lower temperatures? It's true that air frying or using oils like olive oil can reduce some of the risks associated with traditional deep frying. Air fryers cook food by circulating hot air around it, which means you're not submerging your food in potentially harmful oils. This can significantly reduce the production of acrolein and other harmful compounds. However, it doesn't completely eliminate the risks. Even when using an air fryer, the Maillard reaction, a chemical reaction between amino acids and sugars that gives browned food its signature flavor, can still produce advanced glycation end products, ages. These ages are another culprit when it comes to premature aging. They cause oxidative stress and inflammation, contributing to the deterioration of your skin, blood vessels, and organs. So, while air frying is a step in the right direction, it's not a free pass to indulge in fried foods without consequences. Now you might be asking yourself, how much fried food is too much? Can I still enjoy my favorite snacks in moderation? The answer isn't black and white, but here's what we know. The occasional indulgence in fried foods isn't likely to cause lasting damage. The human body is resilient and can recover from small exposures to harmful compounds. However, the real danger lies in frequent consumption. If you're eating fried foods multiple times a week, even in small quantities, you're constantly exposing your cells to damage, and over time, This creates a cumulative effect. One study found that people who regularly consumed fried foods were at a significantly higher risk of developing serious health conditions like heart disease, diabetes, and even cognitive decline. The frequency of consumption matters more than you might think. Just one serving of fried food a week can increase your risk of cardiovascular disease by up to 14%. And if you're eating these foods more often, the risks multiply. So what can we do to combat this? The good news is that it's not all doom and gloom. Your body has an incredible capacity to heal itself when given the right tools. There are foods you can eat that help reverse some of the damage caused by fried foods. Antioxidant-rich foods like berries, leafy greens, and nuts can help neutralize the free radicals produced by harmful compounds like acrolein. These foods support your body's natural detoxification processes and can help slow down the aging process. But the best thing you can do is reduce your intake of fried foods altogether. Opt for baked or steamed options when possible. If you do indulge, try to limit it to special occasions and make sure to pair it with nutrient-dense foods that will help your body recover. Before we wrap up, there's one more critical point I need to make. Even if you think you're using healthy oils like olive or coconut oil for frying, you're not completely in the clear. When oils are heated past their smoke point, the temperature at which they start to break down, they release harmful compounds, including acrolein. Olive oil, for example, has a relatively low smoke point, meaning it can easily degrade into harmful substances when used for frying. Coconut oil, while more stable, can still produce dangerous compounds at high temperatures. So, while these oils are healthier for low-temperature cooking or as salad dressings, they're not ideal for frying. By now, you might be feeling a little uneasy about your next snack. And that's okay. Awareness is the first step toward making better choices for your health. The fried foods that we've come to love, whether it's fries, chips, or even that crispy fried chicken, are silently working against us. They're causing premature aging, damaging our cells, and increasing our risk for serious health conditions. But here's the silver lining. You have the power to change this. By cutting back on fried foods and choosing healthier options, you can slow down the aging process, improve your health, and feel better in the long run. If this information shocked you, or if you learned something new today, make sure to hit that like button and share this video with someone who needs to hear it. Let's spread the word and help more people make informed decisions about what they're eating. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.